Take him, Chris, go! Fast! Go on, all the way!
The other day I stumbled across the first ever recorded footage my family have of me playing proper football. And as my book features never before seen, like, exclusive content, I thought now would be a good time to show you some never before seen footage of me playing football as a 7-year-old. Maybe a bit younger. Like, I'm talking back to the days of football so big you couldn't physically be nutmegged, tears every time you lost the ball, and fearless, uncoordinated flying tackles. But it's enough of me and my sister playing in the garden. We'll start off with the first ever goal I scored, even in a little training match. You might recognise the pitch.
Chris, you can count that as his.
Of course I can count that as my. Are you joking me?
Here he is again. Here he is again. That's astonishing.
I missed the first bit, the brilliant dribble.
And hear that? My dad missed the brilliant dribble. Me taking on those 11 players and then dribbling around the coach, nutmegging him and a few of the parents, then putting it in the back of the net will never be able to be shared with you lot. It's funny how something so unsatisfactory can mean so much, you know, cones for goalposts. Can you imagine playing with a football that size at our age? You wouldn't see many stepovers because it would take about 3 days to complete one. Oh, look at the goals back then. This is a throwback of the fortress as well. So you can see we never actually see the bushes. They never used to be much of an issue. They were just a small sort of plantation of bushes back then. Not the Amazon rainforest we know and we all know and love's a strong word. There's only two highlights from this game, that goal and this. Got the ball, ref. I haven't put that cut in, by the way. That was the camera being shut off as soon as possible at the time. Because as the clip ends, that child could be dead. Oh, look at me, look at me. A lot of this is at my pitch, so you can see why it means so much to me, because I have been playing there literally since I started.
Yes, 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 yes!
Yeah, quite possibly the worst set piece in the last 20 years, only second to that Henri and Pires penalty.
What's he done?
I used to fall over a lot when I was playing when I was very young, and I'm looking at this and I think it's because I used to use quite a lot of the ball to sort of support my weight. I feel like my kneecap was resting on the ball most of the time. So when it got kicked away from me, I was like taken away like an old person's stick. Not that I do that often, should clear that up, but if I did, you know, they'd hit the deck, sorry. This is my first experience of the mitre footballs. Fatality. Good thing I've got sympathetic parents then. Come on, get on with it. Stop crying about it, Jesus. Looks like I'm not having children after all. Right, now the pitch, the kit has changed, and so has the haircut, okay? Look how big the ball is. I wouldn't want to get hit in an adjective with that one either. These games at this age, you probably get like 2-3 seconds of the ball at any time before about 5 players, usually on your own team, just swarmed all over you. So, and then I found some footage from our sitting room, which is still the same shape. Yeah. It's always been a nice rectangular shape with big French windows, so naturally that's a football pitch. Oh, and this was when Ljungberg and Ray Parlour scored like 2 cracking goals to win the FA Cup against Chelsea. Oh, that TV was amazing, by the way. You could crack it with a football, and because old TVs used to be like a couple of feet back, like proper monsters, basically indestructible. Not gonna lie, I did milk the lack of the offside rule in my early years. It was often quite a useful weapon. Good finish, you know? Laces. Foot down. I must say, the goalkeepers leave something to be desired, but a left foot finish. The reactions are a little different across the pitch here, I must say. All right, lads, you scored it, did you? Well, their centre back's like, nope, I'm done. Had enough of this. Not for me. Didn't choose a thug life. All right, we've got another clip of Arsenal winning a trophy. I was just about to say, we need to do this more often, you know? Like, why don't we get the cameras out more when Arsenal are winning trophies? Oh, yeah, that's right. Those are some cracking Arsenal PJs. Kelly wasn't that interested, though. I was a striker right from the start of these early years, and the England kit seemed to be quite popular. And a couple of nice touches and nice finishes here, you know?
Striker! Yeah.
I didn't used to make that many tackles either, but when I did... They know about it. I genuinely think some of the tackles that went in these games are worse than the ones you get these days. Look at this one. It's horrendous. Sorry, Pepe, someone's child has just been two-footed at the waist and they're moving on to some sort of small training game on the small pitch of the fortress. I scored a bunch of goals in this game, all right? You're in for a treat. And this was, you know, you hear those stories about like, oh, when Ronaldinho was this age or when Messi was this age, his side won 10-0 and he scored all 10. This was mine. We begin with this sort of scabby, bouncing, rolling finish into the bottom corner. It just about reaches the goal. Gets under the keeper. There's my first. Now, this is a football better suited to our size. This kid in the trousers gets nutmegged to within an inch of his life. See, this is what I'm talking about. Smaller football. Oh, look. You got nutmegs. Coincidence? I think not. Got my mum's running commentary if we want it.
In the middle, Chris. In the middle. Oh, great. Finish.
Just maybe she should have focused on her filming. Nicely side-footed in. Good technique. Yeah, I'm happy with that one. Well done. And then came the hat-trick clinching goal. Pick that one out. That was nice. Moving on. Kid in the trousers knows that he's going to be crying himself to sleep after that nutmeg, so he's quite angry about it. I used to do this like run where my left arm would stay straight when it should be bent. It's like when you're that young age and you haven't quite got coordination of your limbs yet. They don't quite all work like you want them to yet. Anyway, still enough to get 4 goals in a game, so I'll take it. Right, but those are all the clips I've got for today. Let me know if you do want to see some more stuff like this. I've been working on my video with Fabregas for the last 2 weeks, so that will be out as soon as it's approved, very soon. Thank you for watching and... damn it. Link to pre-order my book is in the description below. Catch you later.